Namaskaraya, all of you. How are you? So today we are going to take the topic versatile nature of carbon in the lesson carbon compounds. So in the last class we discussed about the bonding that is present in carbon atom. Okay, so many things that we see around us are made up of what? Carbon. So many carbon compounds are there. The food we eat, the dress we are wearing, then other articles like car, pen, all things are made up of what? Majority of the things are made up of carbon compound. So did you imagine how this carbon can form so many compounds? Did you imagine about that? So carbon is the element that have the ability to form a large number of compounds. Okay? So here, and that is we are going to discuss here in terms of the versatile nature of carbon. Before that, what is the atomic number of carbon? Atomic number of carbon is 6. So atomic number of carbon is 6. So what is the electronic configuration? Electronic configuration is 2, 4. In the first shell, it has 2 electrons, and in the second shell, it is having 4 electrons. So 4 is the valence electron as well as valency of carbon atom. Okay, so we know that in order to complete octet, usually atoms, they will either transfer their electron or share its electron in order to complete the octet rule or in order to satisfy the octet rule. Okay, so in the case of carbon, since there are 4 valence electrons, there are 2 possibilities. Which are the 2 possibilities? Either carbon can lose 4 electrons, and after losing 4 electrons, it will become C4 plus ion. And what is the other possibility? It can gain 4 more electrons, thus it becomes C4 minus ion. Okay, so in order to complete it, its octet only, they are either sharing, every atom, they are either sharing or losing electrons. So in the case of carbon, since there are 2 possibilities here, that is formation of C4 plus or C4 minus. But in the case of carbon, both the formation of these ions are not possible. We can discuss the first phase, that is C4 plus ion. Here, the carbon atom loses 4 electrons. So after losing 4 electrons, it has 6 protons, and also after losing, it is having 2 electrons. And in order to release electron, a high amount of energy is required. So in the case of carbon, it has to release how many electrons? 4 electrons. So a high amount of energy is required, and that is not possible in the case of a small atom like carbon. Okay? Then, what about the other case? Here also, 6 protons are there. How many electrons are there? It is already having 6 electrons and it gets 4 more electrons. So, 10 electrons. Okay? Since the number of electrons here is more, only 6 protons are there, but the electron is 10. So, as a result of it, what will happen? There will be repulsion between the electron. And we call that repulsion as inter-electronic repulsion. Okay? Inter-electronic repulsion. So, if there is a repulsion between any 2 atoms, which increases the energy, as a result, it will become unstable. So, the possibilities to form C4 minus ion is also not possible. So, what will this carbon atom do? So, in order to overcome all these difficulties, carbon atom share its electron with other atom. Okay? Other atom means it can be carbon atom itself or other atoms like hydrogen, chlorine, oxygen and all. Is it clear? So what type of bond is generally formed by carbon? I told you in the last class that type of bond is known as covalent bond. It forms covalent bond. So carbon atom forms only covalent compounds, not ionic compound. It cannot transfer its electron, or it can transfer of electron means it cannot gain or lose its electron. It only shares its electron with other atom. And such a bond formed is known as covalent bond. Okay. So our topic is about what? The versatile nature of carbon. And before that, in the case of this covalent bond itself, suppose if the shared pair of electron is one means two electrons are there. One pair means two electrons. So one electron will be given by one particular atom, and another electron is given by the other atom. Okay, so they will share its electron and form a bond. If there is one electron pair, we call it as a single bond. And if there are two electron pairs, we call it as a double bond. And if there are three electron pair, we call it as a triple bond. And I'll discuss this topic later. It is coming in our lesson also. I just give you the classification of this covalent bond. Okay, so there are single bond, double bond, and triple bond. Okay, so the reason behind the versatile nature of carbon, or how this carbon atom is giving so much number of compounds, so that is we are going to discuss. And one of the reason for that is, or it is a property, and that property is known as, what is that property? Catenation. Okay, catenation property. Catenation property means it is the ability of carbon atom, and it is a unique ability of carbon atom to form linkages with other carbon atom. And after linking so many carbon atom, what will happen? We get large molecule. And this particular property is known as catenation. So catenation is the unique ability of carbon atom to form bond with other carbon atom, and after that it form a long large molecule. Is it clear? And this catenation can also be after forming chain. You can say in simple words, catenation can be given like this: carbon can bond to another carbon, another carbon, like this, and each carbon is having the valency 4. Okay, again it is bonded to other carbon atom, which is having 4. And this type of molecules are known as what? Straight chain. Straight chain. Okay, they can form, or they one carbon atom linked with another, and they form a straight chain. And another one is, it can form a branch chain. Branch chain means one molecule will be, or one group will be act as a substituent. We can use the term actually substituent. That is, one branching is there from one of the carbon atom. And this category is known as branched chain. So carbon, they can form, or they can form bond with other carbon atom, and that particular property is known as catenation. And after that, it forms so many compounds. And either that compounds are of a straight chain, branched, and another one is ring compounds. Ring compounds. Ring compound means one carbon can combine with other and it form a close ring structure. Okay, it can also form a ring-like compound. So after this catenation property, they can form ring compound, straight chain, and branched chain. So is it clear the property catenation? That is one of the reasons for the versatile nature of carbon. And another property is, the second property is known as what? Tetravalency. Tetra means what? Tetra means four. Okay, so carbon, what is the valency of carbon? It is 4. So at a time, each carbon atom can form bond with 4 other atoms. If it is a monovalent atom, it can form 4 bonds. And it can also form with other atoms like oxygen. And in the case of oxygen, not a double bond will come. That we will discuss. So tetravalency means at a time, each carbon atom can form 4 bonds with other atom, either with hydrogen or with other atoms, and this is known as the tetravalency. So is it clear all of you regarding the versatile nature of carbon atom? So why carbon compound compounds are giving so much compounds? So for that you have to write catenation and tetravalent property and define catenation. That is also another question. So is it clear the versatile nature of carbon compounds? Okay, next we'll discuss about the hydrocarbons and all in the next class. Thank you.